Supergirl is great fun. I love doing it. You know, there's a scheduling situation, better work out schedules. Jeremiah Danvers is still alive until he's killed. And even if he got killed, I'm not even sure he'd be dead, because you can do that on these things. Jeremiah Danvers is still alive. I want him to be a good guy. I'm hoping he's a good guy. I think he's a good guy. I think we sort of established that with what he did with his daughter. And I think he really was trying to help. It'll be interesting to see how he comes back now, because he's been in Cadmus for so long and been away. And there's always a lot of talk about him being Cyborg Superman. I know Cyborg Superman sort of existed in David Harewood's other character. I'll be a little candid here and say David doesn't love playing Cyborg Superman, because he can't see anything out of that one eye, and every time he has a thing on, I smack him. He's playing so many characters. He's such a talented actor. He's playing so many characters, and he felt like that one wasn't as developed, and I agreed with that. And so I thought they were going with the arm of my character, that he was going to be a Cyborg Superman. Maybe that'll happen. You know, I would love to see something happen where we got to come full circle and be able to tell the story. I know Supergirl's picked up for another season, so I would like to be able to bring that character full circle and either to a close or have some sort of a resolution with him. But I feel very confident that he's still alive. Obviously, there's nothing written in stone. I think he's alive, and I think we're going to see him in season 4.
All right, we got a few more questions for you. Sir Moreno.
David Tallman.
Hey, Michael, there you are.
All right, we're going to switch gears a little bit here. I know we're talking all about superheroes and stuff, but just want to say congratulations with Architects of Nile and being a medal award winner. And also, too, just want to know any follow-ups to that right now, or I know we're talking about all IMDb credits and stuff, but you know, just trying to switch gears, just seeing what's going on.
So. I appreciate that, Michael. Yeah, I did a documentary. Took us 5 years to make the documentary, on a serious note. I'm a history major from Princeton University. I take it very seriously. I take, you know, war and diplomacy very seriously. I took my comprehensive exams in that. Using that part of my degree, I did a documentary last year. It took us 5 years to make. It's called Architects in Denial. It dealt with the Armenian genocide that took place from 1915 to 1923. Very terrible event in the world's history, and it was denied by governments that it ever took place. And that denial led directly to the Holocaust and other denials. Plausible deniability allowed other governments to do that. And it's happened a number of times. We've had a number of genocides take place since then. So I did this picture. It was very well received. I was able to go back to Armenia, where I've been a number of times. The president of Armenia, I won the Order of Armenia, which is the highest civilian honor. I meet anybody who's Armenian, they go, thank you for telling the story. And I did a small thing in telling that story. But it also, myself, Montel Williams, who was that producer with me, it sparked something in us, and we are doing more documentaries around human rights and around genocide. And we're doing it currently. We're in the middle of doing a documentary on the rise of anti-Semitism throughout the world and the denial of the Holocaust, which is, for some strange reason, is appearing in a lot of places now. Governments are denying that it ever took place. I mean, I was in Auschwitz in Poland last year in September. You know, the proof is there. It's like the Armenian genocide. People want to sort of sweep it under that didn't exist. And so we're shooting that now. And in between making films like Man Camp, I'm going to go out and do these things. So I find it extremely worthwhile. And you can make a difference in this world. It's a great thing to be able to do. And so, I'm fortunate to be in a position to be able to make this kind of film, so thank you for asking.
Thank you, Gene.
Hi, how
are
you doing,
Dean? I'm doing great, thank you.
All right, I've been a fan for a long time, since I was 8, watching you. So it's a pleasure to see you. My question is that besides Supergirl and Smallville being on your shows, are there any other shows on the CW that you would want to be on? And is there any other movies going forward you want to be on towards the future?
First of all, you were 8 years old when I was doing Superman. I appreciate that. How dare you get out? It just made it clear how much older I am than you. It hurts a lot. It stinks. It stinks a bit. I loved playing the character. The CW world, playing Jeremiah Dane, which is a lot of fun. My son likes to watch Arrow. So I would want to get on that show just so my son would watch me. Because he never watches anything I do. Kids, it's your own kids, right? Oh, all you parents out there, smack your kid. I'm kidding. Oh,
she got one. Again, here's a brochure, man.
No, it's funny. My son never watched those anymore. Because it had DVDs. You know, he had to put a DVD in a player. And kids nowadays, if they can't stream it, it doesn't exist. I was like, what are you doing? What are they? He's like, that's a DVD, Dad. I was like, what? That's not even the oldest thing, but this is called a VHS tape. What the heck is that? And he finally actually watched it. It was airing on Hulu or something. He's like, hey, that's pretty good. Now, I've been trying to tell you that for 15 years, kid. So it was fun. But I don't know if there's anybody that I would want to play particularly right now in the CW. I don't know, but I think the shows are all a lot of fun. So I would be interested in, you know, it'd be fun to play another superhero. There's only been a few people who got to play a couple superheroes. Ryan Reynolds did that, and Ben Affleck has sort of done that, and well, I guess he has, he's at three, really. Two and a half, I don't know. It'd be a lot of fun to play somebody else. I can't think in particular who it would be, but I'd be open to doing that, for sure. Was there one other part of that question that I missed?
Other movies,
yeah, I'm doing movies like crazy, you know, and I'll try and condense my time. See, I'm a single father, and for the last 18 years, my son turns 18 in June. For the last 18 years, I would not take the lead in any television show. I would not take any show that shots out of Los Angeles, a series. I wouldn't do any movie that shot for longer than 3 weeks, because I'm a father first, and I would not be that. So my son turns 18 on the 11th of June, and I'm going to throw him out of the house and go back to work. but it allows me to do anything and to travel a lot more and take, and if I want to take the lead in the series, I can now consider that. There's a lot of things that I turned down in the last 18 years, because once you do the lead of a series, that's your life. That's what you're doing 24/7 basically for 10 months a year.
Dean, last question. Show me.
Hi, Dean.
How are you?
Good. I'd like to know, what was your favorite scene, part, or moment from Lois and Clark?
Very good question. Were you even old enough to see it?
I've seen some of the episodes.
All right.
It was negative.
It was negative 30, I think, as a young man. My favorite moment, like even out there on the little table where you have pictures of Lois and Clark and things like that, and Superman. My favorite picture there is a black and white one where Lois is behind Clark and she's pulling open the S, and the S is in color. That sort of, to me, typified what the show is about. It's about the relationship between them, and yes, he's got the Superman thing, but she helps him have his strength and know who he is. So the moment, one of my favorite moments that I thought was magical on the show was when Clark Kent proposes to her. And it's raining, like we might have been in New Jersey at the time. And it's raining, and he's about to ask her, and of course it starts pouring rain, and he's asked her to marry him, and she says, who's asking, Clark or Superman? So that was the whole thing. That to me was the greatest moment in the show that I remember.
Thank you, Dave. Another big round of applause for a great star. As Dina mentioned, of course it's Memorial Day weekend, and it is very important that at a time like this that we take a minute to recognize that sacrifice that our veterans have made for our country, that ultimate sacrifice. And if you think about it, I want to bring up some members of law enforcement who are here with us today and their families. Come on up, guys. Law enforcement events, the 200 clubs. Give these guys a round of applause. These are the real heroes. They serve our communities. They see them get home at the end of that shift. So be mindful as you celebrate the Memorial Day weekend that these guys are out there serving us every single day. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
The next 3 weeks, I'll actually be sworn in as a reserve police officer in St. Anthony's, Idaho as well. So because that's how much respect I have for you guys. So I'll go on to the floor with you guys. Much respect. Thank you so much.
You guys, just say your name and where you serve.
George Ortega, State Parole.
Steve Fornerato, Department of Corrections.
Trooper Gentile, Pennsylvania State Police.
Officer Ortiz, New Jersey State Parole.
Sean Campbell, Elizabeth Police Department.
Give him a big round of applause. He's good. I want to just do a one more.
With the Elizabeth Police Department, and he also plays offensive tackle.
He's the opponent I've been waiting for. But unbeatable? No. Superman has morals. He has ethics. He's unrelentingly good. Because of that, I will win.
Guys can all face this way. All in. All right, now you guys know the drill. Everybody know the drill? Gather right here behind me. We're in the light.
You can see the camera.
I can see. Wait. Going this way. Everybody, point at the camera. Camera, ready? There you go.
Yes.
Outstanding. Thank you, guys.